Hey, welcome to another edition of Vino Squared on Wine. So today I'm drinking a little Riesling and tell you a little bit about Riesling so you get a good understanding. Primarily, there's three different levels of Riesling. You have Tafel wine, which is their table wine, and you have what they call QBA, which is their quality levels of wine. And you don't need to know how to say this, but it's Qualitäts Bestimme an Augebiet. Okay, so that is that level. I don't expect you to ever remember that. And then you have QMP, which is Qualitäts mit Prädikat. And these are basically your upper level wines. They're all predicated wines. And these wines are based on sugar and varying degrees of sugar. It's what they call in Germany, Uxla. So Uxla is the sugar levels. Now, when we get past QBA, and there's primarily, I think it's five or six, but I'll say them because I still remember them. But it's Spätlesen, Auslesen, Bieren Auslesen, Trocken Bieren Auslesen, and Eiswein. And each one of those goes up in sugar level as you go along. Auslesen basically stands for out late. Trocken Bieren Auslesen stands for dried berries out late. It's pretty easy once you start to understand the language and how it goes with the wine. So I'm going to show you a label, and you'll see on this particular label that it says that it is a predicated wine. This one happens to be from Dr. Lucin. It comes from one of my favorite regions, which is Moselle. And Moselle is like these slate granite walls, which really stress vines, and they're hard to grow. And Germany's cold anyways. So let me show you this label and you'll see it. Rotbier. I'll turn it all the way around. Get a little glare off of it. But you'll see where it says predicated wine of Germany. So depending on what you like to drink and what you're looking to pair is really going to determine what level of these wines you're going to want to procure. Also, the more sugar content, and it kind of goes up in quality, they're going to go up in price as well. So it's going to be a matter of what does my pocketbook afford me. Now in Germany, there's not a ton of red wines that come out of there. So you might want to just focus on one, and that one is called Spätburgunder. And in the United States, we call that Pinot Noir. So if you're in your wine shop and you're looking around and you see Spätburgunder, just know that that's going to be a German style of Pinot Noir. And they taste quite a bit different than ours, but they have some really great nuances to them. So anyways, I just wanted to share a little bit about Rieslings. Like I said, they're going to go up in sweetness levels, so you really have to figure out which one you prefer to drink at. For me, I drink at, it's one that I skipped, the very first one. I drink at the cabinet level, as which this wine is cabinet level. So that's just past the QBA. The first entry level predicated wine is cabinet level. So I'll do it one more time. It's cabinet, Spätlesen, Auslesen, Bieren Auslesen, Trocken Bieren Auslesen, and Eiswein. All right, remember those. When you go to the store, you can look them up, see them, find some really great Rieslings to share with your friends during the summer. They're just great with Thai food. They're great with Chinese. They complement a lot of spicy dishes. So if you're out there having some spicy foods, you're going to want to dive into a nice Riesling to go with it. All right, that's it today from Vino Squared on Wine. We'll see you guys next time. Behave in your cave.